Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers, back in 1995, I published a little thing called Avery's Theory Number 1, which was a rebuttal to Darwin's theory, where I said that dinosaurs were made extinct by man, and basically that Darwin's theory of evolution is a load of crap. And it's even, like, I put a little thing at the end of it, when you sort of contradict the Bible even a little bit, when you add a bit of science fiction to the Bible, and God made sleep fall upon men, and he, Adam, and he took part of the rib bone and made Eve. Well, maybe someone, a higher power, came down in a flying saucer, like you just saw there, took a rib, made Adam fall asleep, i.e. made him unconscious, grafted a piece of bone, and cloned a female version of Adam. So you can sort of say that. But see, the thing is, there's been dinosaurs around for a long time, but we only called them dinosaurs for the last 100 years or so. Before that, they were called dragons. Dragons. The Bible spoke of them. There is a lot of myth. Everybody say dragons are mythical. The only thing missing from a Tyrannosaurus Rex and the dragon are those frilly little bits around the ears. Not the fact that they were little bloody things. Sorry, I got somewhere along the line, I got a dog hitting the keyboard. It was driving me nuts. Sorry about that, folks, and I'm not going to stop the video. But we have there, that was a shot of Nessie. Now, we've got pictures of knights with lances. Okay, now some of you are going to ask me why about that and think to yourself, what's this guy got pictures of bloody knights in there? Maybe because the knights killed them. See, look at the Tyrannosaurus Rex. It's missing something. We've got ears. I think the Tyrannosaurus Rex and all these dinosaurs had ears, but that was the shape of their ears. They had little frilly bits of skin. You start adding those to a dinosaur's, what do you get? You get a dragon. And then we come along to this bloke called St. George the Dragon Slayer. He became a saint because he killed dragons. You imagine it. You're running down a road from a dragon, but you're not actually running down the road from a dragon. You could even be running down the road from a herbivore. Because even to men, back then, a herbivore was bloody dangerous. You think about it, back in the 12th and 6th century, okay, where's this poor bastard's ears? It's missing. See, modern day scientists have covered them over. They've used a technique that is used for humans, where they overlay muscles in certain patterns, and then they come up with the shape of these things. Well, they forgot a few things. They forgot the things like ears. And as I said, the ears were those frilly little bits that are missing on the dinosaurs that you see on every picture of a dragon. Now, those little arms, in some of these pictures, you're going to see that those little arms on some of the dinosaurs weren't actually arms. They may have been wings. And the thing is, you have to turn around and start thinking, okay, between Darwin and this guy that started calling them dinosaurs, they weren't dinosaurs, folks. They were dragons. The thing is, when we turned around and reshaped them, we turned around and we forgot their ears. Because the moment you start adding ears to them, okay, that's a modern day picture of a dragon. Okay? It's still missing its ears. Yet in all these other ones, they have ears. But they're in the shape of a frilly bit, like the frill neck lizard. And they pop out. Well, maybe these guys, see, they had the little frilly bits. That was their ears. That was part of them. They weren't bones, so they never included them. Yet you could turn around and put a Tyrannosaurus skull in that, and blow and behold, what do you got? You have a dragon. Those horns could have been cartilage. Cartilage deteriorates better than bone. Okay, all we still have a skeletal structure underneath that, but it's missing heaps of stuff. It's missing the ears, it's missing all the little frilly bits that the dragons had. Dragons have been known of since back in Sumerian times, Egyptian times, winged serpents. Okay, winged serpents. A dragon, okay, let me think. A dragon's a reptile. Reptiles are serpents. So plesiosaurs, pterosaurs, pterodactyls. God, you name it. I don't know all the names of the dinosaurs. I know some of them. But the Bible used to call some of them behemoth. Okay, the behemoth could have been the brontosaurus. But yet, back in the 1500 or the 1200s, for quite a few hundred years, we had these dirty big high castle walls with windows and little windows and everything so that we could fight off things. It wasn't for fighting off bloody soldiers. They were fighting off these things. That's why these bloody knights wore 70 kilo of armour, so that these bastards didn't bite them. Sit down, mutt. And so they were there to protect the horses, that was there to protect the knights. And the lances was there to kill them. When you think about it, you jam a lance into the ground while you're standing there, and you drive it in the ground because you've got one of these bastards chasing after you. A lance is a damn good weapon. Jousting was actually practice for killing these things. It was nothing else but practice for killing these things. Okay? Think about it. Now, we get told that the arms were like this. Maybe some of them didn't have arms exactly like that. Maybe those arms were switched around the other way and the scientists got it wrong. Right? All they've done with these things is they've recreated the bone structure and they've put muscles over it the same way we do. Look at that armour. That's got a picture of a bloody dragon on it. Why's it got a picture of a dragon on it? Because these guys slayed dragons. Yes, they fought in wars. But before that, the armour was created to protect them from the dragons. It was left over from the floods. Right, the big flood. Right? So maybe, yeah, the Bible is bloody dead true. The lance is the perfect weapon for killing dragons. Yet it's a cumbersome weapon on a horse. Now, look at this. You imagine you're up against one of these spikes. You're going to want pretty substantial armour, and you're going to want pretty substantial weapons. These guys, okay, again, they've just covered the bone structure. They haven't added the little cartilage bits that were their ears and their little decorations, like peacocks have all these decorations in their feathers. Maybe dinosaurs had the same thing, and we used to call them dragons. St. George the Dragon Slayer, the most famous one of all. We have actually physically changed the look of these creatures by not including skin features. This one had bony structure up his back. He looks closer to a dragon than anything. Now, only a fool would try and debunk this video. Because only a fool would turn around and say, oh, dragons didn't exist. Well, maybe if they turn around and go and do a bit of research. See, dinosaurs didn't turn into bloody chickens. Dinosaurs were killed off. I'm sorry to tell you, they were killed off by M-A-N, man, us. Some of them still survive today. We know one is a Loch Ness Monster, one is another creature, there's one in Africa. I think there was a smaller one seen by Vladimir Putin. And there's numerous sightings of lake monsters and things like that. You can even see some of them in Google Earth. But you think about it, you're going down a bush track and all of a sudden one of these bastards come at you. For God's sake, you're not going to call it a dinosaur. You're going to call it a dragon, because the word dragon was the name for them before we started calling them dinosaurs. Dragons weren't a myth. Dragons are dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are dragons. You just have to realise it. Even these big blokes were still called dragons. Look at it. That looks like a dragon. And again, we've missed all the little frilly bits. We've just covered over the bone with skin the exact same way that we build facial reconstruction. That's how all these images come about. They haven't added, like, the ears, the frilly ears. You start adding frilly ears, and I'm telling you now, if you're one of these archaeologists that have done all this shit, start that. Look at dinosaurs. By the way, that's a trail camera. Caught a picture of a... Looks like it could be a dinosaur, it could be the ape man, or it could be a Sasquatch, I don't know, actually. But look at it. They're walking on two legs, got wings right where the arms are. Well, maybe It's missing part of the arms are missing part of the things that were cartilage. And again, look at the armour. These guys wore this armour not to protect themselves from bloody other soldiers. These were built wholly and solely for killing these buggers. That's what the armour was designed for. This is why the horses had armour themselves. Look at that. No little arms. This one's got wings, right, where the little arms were. That's actually chalk drawing. Sorry, I left that one in, but it's of one of the so-called lake creatures. I think that's the Alaskan one or something. Now, look at this. This is back in the 20s. Boy Scout holding a pterosaur. And again, knight's armour. Start putting two to two together. Stop being idiots and stop listening to the crap that all these archaeologists have been telling you, because even the archaeologists have been misled, because they've been told by their previous professor, this is the way it was, that's the way it is, because you've been told in a room, that's what it was. See, what they're missing are these little frilly bits. They start putting these little frilly bits onto the dinosaurs, what do we get? We get dragons. They're missing certain features of the dinosaurs. Maybe there were other parts of these dinosaurs that they're not telling us about as well, like wings, the flying thing. Because maybe they don't want us to know that dinosaurs were actually dragons and dragons were real. You saw that walking over the hill, you're not going to call it a friggin' dinosaur back in 1200. That's a dragon. Wake up, people of the world. Wake the hell up. That is a real picture of a pterodactyl flying over a city. A pterodactyl. There was a pterosaur reported over the city of Newcastle a couple of years ago. Ring our local rangers at the council. They'll tell you all about it. That is a dinosaur, folks. One of the lake monsters. That's not Nessie. It's one of the lake monsters, though. There's a dinosaur. That's a dragon, dinosaur, dragon, same bloody thing. You got to get your foot out of your asses. And maybe the scientists need to put their heads up their asses, and I'm sorry to say this, folks, but that's true. These archaeologists are either lying to us or they've got their head up their ass. Because they've got to start realising and say, and call them by the name they have been known by for hundreds of bloody years. They were called dragons. Dragons existed. They had little wings. Okay, that one. Maybe the wings were something that were just on them. That one looks like a more advanced bloody, what do you call it, that one that's still alive. That's okay, fair enough. That's a depiction of a pterosaur. I can't think of the name of it. I'll get it. Yeah, it's that one that's on that island. And again, think about it. Armour. It's got a dragon on it. Why has it got a dragon on it? It had a dragon for a reason, because these blokes bloody killed them. And again, it's got the frilly little bits. It's got the frilly little wings walking on two legs. Two bloody legs. Just like a dinosaur. A plesiosaur. Swimming. That's one of the shots of Nessie. Nessie's real. Nessie still lives. Or Nessie was the one that got pulled up by that Japanese trawler that was all rotted. Look under must-see government secrets. Look under strange creatures. Go onto YouTube and have a look around. And seriously, you're going to start to see some of these. A Chinese bloke found a young version of one of these. And he's gutting it. These are real dinosaurs. Existed, that's a modern day depiction. Fair enough, they sort of, the wings are a little bit overboard. But you think about it. It's the perfect reasoning why these blokes are wearing this sort of armour. It wasn't to stop swords. It would stop, because these things, you put a sword through a piece of armour, yeah, it's going to bloody go through. But it would stop a claw slicing across it. Again, that's a real picture of a pterosaur. That's a modern-day picture, by the way. So you've got to start to realise, ancient art. Ancient art depicts dragons. But 100 years ago, some guy after Darwin turned around and said they were dragons because of Darwin. Darwin was bloody wrong. The theory of evolution is a load of bullshite. Okay? Evolution, the way we have... Mankind has most probably been around for millions of years. Okay? The Bible could be actually older than we think. We've been told it's a couple of thousand years. What if the Bible was actually a couple of million years ago? It was originally written a couple of million years ago. They've actually found spark plugs in rocks. Hundreds of years old. Millions of years old. They found a giant gear out in the desert. You need to start looking out there and look for yourself. Stop listening to the crap that they tell you and do some bloody research. Get out there and do some reading. You go out there and do some reading, you're going to start to find out that all this crap that you're being told is bullshit. The governments want you to be mushrooms because the governments are ruled by the Illuminati. The Illuminati is ruled by what we call the devil, right? Because they admit it. They worship Lucifer. Lucifer was a dragon. Maybe there is an intelligent dragon out there. Again, look at it. Two legs. No little arms. Maybe those little arms were part of the bloody wing. Okay, that's a modern day depiction of an allosaur. But now you look at the allosaur. It's a bloody dragon. And yeah, I'm passionate about this one. Because I'm so sick and damn tired of people calling them dinosaurs. They weren't called dinosaurs. And I'm telling you now, you archaeologists really need to start seriously thinking and start telling the truth. Because you can't hide it anymore. Dinosaurs are what was once called dragons. And you need to start referring to them by their correct name. Not the bullshit name that some idiot came up with 100 years ago. Refer to them by the name of what they were once called. They're those bloody dragons I was trying to think of the name of, but I can't think of their name. They still exist. Crocodiles are a dragon. We still have living dragons. And as I said, even these herbivores still would have terrified people. But they could have been utilised by people. Okay, now that's a modern day version picture of a dragon. But look at it. They've based it on a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Now there is a dinosaur swimming in the ocean. A dinosaur. That's not a whale. That's a dinosaur. It had legs, didn't have a tail like a whale. And again, St. George the Dragon Slayer. That's not, I don't know if that's St. George, but all these things had, that one's actually in Africa, by the way. That's the one of the African ones. There are reports of lake monsters all over the world. Now, you look at that. That could be the raptor, but look at the ears on it. They could have been cartilage ears. Those webbings could have been cartilage. Yet none of these dinosaurs have ears. We have ears. Maybe the dinosaurs had ears too, because all the old depictions got it. They've got damn frilly ears on them. So, debunkers. Go out of the room. Scratch your head. And think, shit, we've been lied to. Because look at this, Civil War America. What is that? Oh my God, it's a friggin' pterodactyl. St. George the Dragon Slayer, a picture of the time. What is it of? St. George killing a dragon. Guess what, folks? That's actually a modern day picture of, guess what? A pterosaur in Africa. St. George killing a dragon. It's got wings. And it's got its frilly little bloody ears. Maybe we start to need to rethink every single picture of a dinosaur out there. Start adding the ears to them. And get, what do we get? We get dragons. We need to start referring to them by the name that they were bloody given way back when, even in biblical times. They were called dragons. I hate to tell you folks, they were called dragons. This one, in Africa, the Mokromombre, yeah, it's over 100 years, natives have been talking about this thing. What does it look like? A brontosaurus. I showed you the picture of it. Okay, this one's got wings. It's got those frilly little bloody ears. And you've got to remember, these are Renaissance paintings. Why were they painting them? Because these people saw them. And it starts to put some logic to why these guys wore this armour, why they used the lances, and why castles had such bloody strong gates, because these bastards could be dangerous. Look at that. That's with its ears and its little whiskers all made of cartilage. The same way alligators have cartilage. That one looks like an Allosaurus. Oh, that's got the teeth like the Allosaurus. But that's St. George, the Dragon Slayer, killing a dinosaur. We called them dinosaurs. Modern man called them dinosaurs. They weren't dinosaurs. They're bloody dragons. You've got to turn around and start looking at some of the modern day art of dragons and start saying, okay, well, if I take that component and I put that on a Tyrannosaurus Rex, and then I get this knight, and he's there charging a dragon, a joust would be a very good way to practice. Now, you look at the way they are staved into the stand there. You've got a dragon coming after you. You stand there and you drive the end of your stave into the ground, and it's going to drive straight into the most vital parts of that dragon. And it's the perfect length for killing a large dragon or a large dinosaur. A sea monster is a bloody plesiosaur or one of the other ones. We haven't even explored the depths of our oceans yet. Multi-headed dragons. For God's sake, we have multi-headed calves, multi-headed dogs, multi-headed kittens. Maybe there were multi-headed dragons too. A freak of nature. So we've got to turn around and start thinking, okay, again, we've been lied to by these bastards with little brushes, and they're telling us these things are dinosaurs, where once upon a time they were called dragons. Look at that. If you, as I said, if you're running down the road and you've got that thing chasing you, it's called a dragon. You're screaming into the castle. Everybody gets rushed into the castle. That's why all the citizens ran into the castle. They didn't run from the armies. Half the time, citizens just used to let the armies go past them. But for a certain period of time in the Dark Ages, when all this stuff was happening, because that's most of when all this dragon stuff happened, was the so-called Dark Ages. The Dark Ages were when these dragons were about. It was St. George's time. And basically, they built these castles so that these mongrels couldn't get them. The whole country, the whole village used to rush into the castle when one of these things were around. Because that looks like a dinosaur. Yet that's an old sculpture of St. George the Dragon Slayer. So why are there so many people out there saying, oh, they're a dinosaur, it's a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Okay, we've given them names now. Yeah, we still can call it a Tyrannosaurus Rex, but it doesn't look like that. We've forgotten its frilly little ear, like its frilly ears with the little points on it, made of cartilage. We've forgotten its little pieces of wings. We've redesigned them to suit ourselves. Maybe the scientists need to go and look at some of this history and say, okay, that's what they really look like. Maybe we need to go and do a bit more research and re-put some of these bones in the right position. And that's, I can't think of the name of that damn bloody dragon. Komodo dragon, that's it. A mortally wounded dragon, killed by St. George, carved in ivory. St. George the Dragon Slayer. He became a saint for killing dragons and protecting the people. They made him a saint for it. Okay, they made him a saint. So if they're making him a saint for killing dragons, why don't we see any bones of dragons? Because we do. We go into any museum and we can see bloody dragon bones. But we call them dinosaurs. All I'm asking is these archaeologists turn around and say, okay, yes, we've changed the name. But they were originally called dragons. This one, dragon was the Tyrannosaurus Rex. This one was a Triceratops. This dragon was a Brontosaurus. This one was a, yeah, a raptor or whatever. This one was that one. But they were dragons. Some of them had wings. But all we're missing are those little frilly bits of the dragon. Maybe these wings were, again, just cartilage. They didn't turn into birds because we killed them off. There hasn't been time enough for evolution to turn them into birds. The shit about them turning into little roosters and crap like that is all bullshit. They were of the same family. The roosters were roosters back then. They didn't evolve. They were just part of the family. Like apes are part of our family. But we didn't evolve from apes. They were just part of our family of beings. Similar DNA. Just the way we were made. So you start putting evidence. And I've presented enough evidence through historical fact. Through starting to put some of the, not just the images, but turn around and put some of the facts, like the armour. Why'd these guys have armour? Why'd they have lances? Mate, the missing parts of the dragons. That's all I've done. I've just put all the evidence together for you. So go away and have a good long think about it. It's called Avery's Theory. As I said, maybe we've even got it wrong about God. Maybe some super being came down here that is actually super powerful and does everything that we've said God does. And maybe he came down and made a sleep fall upon Adam. In other words, Adam got abducted, had a bone taken out of him. They genetically cloned Eve. We had Adam and Eve. By cloning. Makes sense. That's what God did. He turned around, took a bone from Adam and made Eve. And there you go, folks. That's actually Avery's theory. As I said, I come up with a concept back in, maybe a little bit before 1995. I actually published it back in 1995. And because GeoCities and everything, I decided to actually redo it. But as I said, you've got to start thinking like doing something. That was St. George's tomb. So St. George was a real person. He was sainted for the fact that he killed these creatures. He protected people. So you talk about, okay, here we go. All we've done is modern science has forgotten a few pieces. Okay, dragons breathing fire. Okay, you've got dragons, a lot of rotten food in their gullet. That actually looks like a modern day dinosaur. But you've got like a beast with a lot of food in its gullet. We fart methane. Maybe these guys, when they burp, someone was trying to scare it off with a fire, and that dragon has either burped or breathed forward and breathed out methane. What do you got? You've got a fire-breathing dragon, because these people are trying to scare it away with a torch. You've lit its breath. And even debunkers can't say, oh, that can't happen. It actually can. Every time you fart methane. Methane burns. These guys might have farted through what's called a burp. You think about it, they've got a lot of rotten meat in their bellies. So you start adding all these little frilly bits to a Tyrannosaurus Rex. What do you get? You get a dragon. Those horns may have been part of the thing. So some of these horn beasts, they have, but the ears, we're missing the ears, like that frill one that pops its bloody neck out. Maybe the wings weren't that big. Maybe they were just cartilage. And okay, so we start looking at cartilage wings. That one's a fake, by the way, but the thing is, maybe the certain parts of the wings weren't bones. They were a descendant. They were certain things. They were across. They didn't make it all the way to the pterosaur. But then maybe there were other flying dragons. We've got the bones out there, folks, but they're not dragon bones. They're not dinosaur bones, folks. They are dragon bones. Dragons. As I said, put the ears on that thing, those frilly little bits. What have we got? We have a dragon. And yet there's so many people out there, oh, dragons are a myth. Because there's no there's no dragon bones, but we've got plenty of dinosaur bones, but we have no dragon bones. Because what we've forgotten to put their little frilly ears on it. We've forgotten to put their little whisker-type things on it. And we've just reconstructed them using the techniques that we construct man. We're not reconstructing man. We're reconstructing a dinosaur. Okay, a dinosaur had other little bits on it. Okay, chooks. Good example. Chooks have crowns and manes and combs and little bits coming off it. Same family. Think about it. Those frilly little bits that are missing off of dinosaurs, maybe they were made the same way as they are on roosters and chooks. Okay, birds. So maybe that they were a little bit related. But the thing is, dinosaurs exist. Some still exist today. So go away, have a think about it. And write.